Hi friends, and welcome back to another discussion on the mandibular nerve specific in this infratemporal fossa. And here we're going to talk about the divisions of the mandibular nerve and follow all of its branches. So we're going to use this illustration to walk us through it. Earlier we saw that the motor root and V3 will pass here through this foramen ovale. And then immediately inferior to foramen ovale, V3 will course between the tensor veli palatini muscle and the lateral pterygoid muscle. Now we see the three parts. So first is the trunk, or the main trunk of V3. And we have branches coming off of there. Up here, we see the anterior division, and then finally the posterior division. And I'll note that on here, anything in yellow is only sensory. Motor we see is this brown color. And then anything containing both is found here in orange. So we'll start here with the trunk. Directly off the trunk, we see many branches, one of which is the nerve to the medial pterygoid, which we've seen previously as one of the branches here. We also will find that the nerve to the tensor veli palatini here and the nerve to the tensor tympani will come off of the trunk. And typically together, we also see this meningeal branch, which will re-enter the cranial cavity through foramen spinosum, supplying sensory innervation to that area. The anterior division is another portion we've spoken about earlier in terms of the muscles of mastication. So the branches coming off of it, most of them are motor branches. We see the nerve to lateral pterygoid, which we may find coming off of the main part of the anterior trunk or later off of this buccal nerve. We also see branches to the masseter, the masseteric nerve, and the deep temporal nerves to the temporalis muscle. After these motor branches come off, then we follow, and this remaining sensory branch is the long buccal or the buccal nerve. And we'll remember we saw this passing between the two heads of the lateral pterygoid muscle. From the posterior division, we see here the auriculotemporal nerve with its relationship in the middle meningeal artery wrapping around it. Then we see the two major branches, more inferior, medial, anterior, the lingual nerve, and more laterally entering into the mandible, the inferior alveolar nerve. You'll see here the inferior alveolar nerve in orange because, as well as being a sensory branch to teeth and then to the lower lip and chin, we see the nerve to the mylohyoid will come off of it before it enters into the mandibular foramen. Now, this nerve will supply mylohyoid muscle but also the anterior belly of digastric. In terms of sensory innervation, V3's dermatome is quite expansive. We'll remember our major sensory branches that supply the area of the skin, one of which is coming from this area, and that will be our mental nerve. Another runs right along here, and that is the buccal nerve. And the final major sensory branch of V3 that will supply the dermatome is going to be for this region up here, and that is the auriculotemporal nerve. I wanted to bring back the visual that you saw from a previous session with me of V3. So you'll remember this main trunk in our other visual passing between the lateral pterygoid muscle and the tensor veli palatini. Then we see way over here our lateral pterygoid muscle. So obviously in schematics, things are a little bit more spread out. We're also going to find that this is a fairly short area, this anterior division, as it's giving off many of those muscular branches right away. So exaggerated length of the anterior division here, but I'll show you kind of the relationship between both the trunk and the anterior division with lateral pterygoid muscle and with the levator vili palatini. We can also add on here the nerve to the mylohyoid. So previously we talked about that inferior alveolar nerve ending in the mental nerve, the cutaneous branch there. Before the inferior alveolar nerve enters into the mandibular foramen, it gives off this branch, the nerve to the mylohyoid muscle, and we'll see it kind of has two branches here to represent that it will also supply the anterior belly of digastric. I also wanted to point out on a donor, we'll remember our posterior division branches here into the inferior alveolar nerve and the lingual nerve. So here's lingual nerve. Here is IAN or inferior alveolar nerve. And then we can see this tiny branch coming off before the mandibular foramen that will go to supply the mylohyoid in the anterior belly of digastric. Now, in contrast, we see a smaller branch in the infratemporal fossa running in this direction and then toward lingual nerve. Now that is not the nerve to the mylohyoid muscle. Instead, what is that one? So that is representing what we've got over here on the right. That's the chorda tympani nerve. So a branch of facial nerve joining in to follow the lingual nerve. So here we can see the relationship between the muscles and V3. If we pause here, we'll be able to identify first most laterally this lateral pterygoid muscle, then the tensor vili palatini, and finally most medially levator vili palatini. So remember, relationship-wise, we see the V3 is exiting foramen ovale between the two muscles, lateral pterygoid and tensor vili palatini. And then the anterior division will course between the superior and inferior heads of lateral pterygoid muscle on the way to their targets. In this visual, it is not perfect in terms of that anterior division, but hopefully you get the idea of how both of those relationships can be the case in this small, small area. All right, so for this question, definitely pause it. I want you to list all muscles innervated by V3. So go ahead, pause, write down as many as you can think of, and maybe even write down the name of the branch that supplies them. And then when you're ready, check in with me and we'll talk through all of them. All right, hopefully you have a list coming along. We're kind of thinking of these in groups, hopefully. And all of these muscles develop with V3 in the first pharyngeal arch. So let's take it with the parts of V3. So off of the trunk of V3, two muscles are innervated from branches here. What are they? So one of them is tensor vili palatini. The next, tensor tympani. One other muscle actually here will be the medial pterygoid muscle. Okay, now what about off of the anterior division? So these will fall into the same group as the medial pterygoid muscle, the muscles of mastication. So we see the masseter, temporalis, and lateral pterygoid. Great. Now, how about that posterior division? When we think posterior division, we really don't think about motor innervation, but we'll remember that small branch off of inferior alveolar nerve. What will that supply? So that branch is the nerve to the mylohyoid. And that also supplies a muscle very closely associated with the mylohyoid, the anterior belly of digastric. Now, hopefully you're able to write down a couple of these muscles, and right away when you hear V3, you want to be thinking about the muscles of mastication. And now we can start to add on these newer muscles, the tensors and the mylohyoid with the anterior belly of digastric. And this is a nice kind of way to put it all together and talk about all of the motor innervation of V3. You could do something similar on your own for the sensory innervation of V3. And if you have any questions at all, never hesitate to ask. Thank you so much for your attention, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.